Hello students, welcome to Affairs Cloud. My name is Vikas.
We have an app by the name Careers Cloud which you can go and download through Play Store. Once you have downloaded the application, you will be able to easily log in using your Gmail ID. Once you have logged in, you will be redirected to this page where you will be getting this UI and there will be option for Home, All Courses, My Courses and Doubt section. On this application, you will be getting multiple PDFs, multiple content on daily basis that will be enhancing your learning. Our first segment is daily current affairs. We make sure to provide you current affairs on daily basis in both English as well as in Hindi content. The PDFs for the same are uploaded on our application, and apart from this, we also make sure to provide you with quizzes that will help you to revise the content after you have gone through the PDF. Next comes our weekly content. The content is also provided in both English as well as in Hindi, and here we also make sure to provide you quiz also of that past week's current affairs that will be enhancing your learning, as it is a compilation of the important topics, important MCQ questions for the last week. Similar for the monthly, the PDFs are very important. They provide you insights of various topics, as well as we also make sure to provide you the quiz of monthly questions that are very important for learning. Next, we also provide you with important PIB articles on daily basis so that you can go through these articles and have an insight about that particular topic. Not just this, we also make sure to provide you important events that are happening globally and make sure to give you the right analysis. One of the most important segments of our application is that we make sure to provide you with the correct exam analysis. When you are having exam, we make sure to provide you with the previous year questions so that the student can go through the exam pattern and the syllabus and can prepare the exam accordingly based on the pattern. After the exam, we also make sure to provide you with the exam analysis. Then for the students who are preparing for state exams, they will be also beneficial here, as we will make sure to provide with state-wise current affairs for them. Apart from this, we also make sure to cover the topic-wise current affairs such as your national affairs, government schemes, international affairs, banking and finance, economy and businesses, as these are the topics from which the examiner definitely asks the question, and these are covered on the monthly basis. So friends, do check our application. It will be a one-stop solution for learning. Apart from this, friends, Careers Cloud is hiring. We are looking for candidates for subject matter experts in quants, reasoning and English, and also we are looking for a content creator for current affairs topic on daily basis, weekly basis and monthly basis. There is also an opening for a person who can translate the English content into Hindi. If you want to apply, you can scan the code here for further details, or you can go to the description and click the link below. These positions are available both in full-time and freelance for serious candidates. Hello everyone. So in this video, we will be discussing important current affairs for national affairs for the January month. Session will be quite interesting and important, so do pay attention till the end. Let's start. First question is, which state government has recently ranked first for the third consecutive year in recording the highest entries on the Interoperable Criminal Justice System platform, that is ICJS platform? So which is the state that has secured the first position on this Interoperable Criminal Justice System? It is Uttar Pradesh. So right option is option 1. Uttar Pradesh secured the first position, and this is for the third consecutive year that it secured the first position, right? And on second position, it was Madhya Pradesh, correct, and Bihar on the third position. In Uttar Pradesh, for the first position, we saw entries of 1,56,22,514 entries. That is the highest entries in this ICJS platform. Then if we talk about this ICJS platform, Interoperable Criminal Justice Platform, this is an initiative of Supreme Court of India, correct? It was implemented by Ministry of Home Affairs and it was launched in 2013, correct? And in simple terms, if we say Interoperable Criminal Justice System portal, this ICJS portal, remember, this acts as a centralized database of criminal records. Centralized database of criminal records, correct? ICJS portal. Next question is, in December, Ministry of Finance imposed a definitive anti-dumping duty on imports of
wheel loaders from Dash country for a period of 5 years. So Ministry of Finance, they imposed a definitive anti-dumping duty, that is a tax on imports of wheel loaders from China, correct? And it will be for a period of 5 years. The duty rates, that means here your interest, correct? Or we can say they will be charged ranging from 18.84% to 82.71%. This will vary upon the producer and goods. For different types of goods, the percentage here will be different. And this duty will be applicable on the imports of complete build unit, right? That is, fully build unit will be, this duty will be on that, correct? First thing. Second, on the semi knockdown forms and not completely knockdown forms, correct? Take a note of this. So Ministry of Finance, they imposed a definitive anti-dumping duty on imports of wheel loaders from China for a period of 5 years, and the duty rates here will be 18.84% to 82.71%. that will depend upon the producer and the goods, and these goods will be basically your CBU goods, that is your completely built units. Next, as of Jan, Dash State is set to build India's first artificial intelligence city to promote the AI ecosystem. If we talk about AI, AI is your artificial intelligence. When was the first time we came to know, or by which product we came to know about artificial intelligence? That is your ChatGPT. ChatGPT was launched by OpenAI. Who is the CEO of OpenAI? Sam Altman. Right, now we are talking about another AI software engineer or AI software developer, that is Devin. This Devin launched by Cognition Labs. Question asked here is that which state is set to build India's first AI city to promote the AI ecosystem? So UP will be setting up. UP is the state that will be building India's first AI city. And which city it will be? It will be Lucknow. India's first AI city will be in UP, and which city it will be? It will be Lucknow. Lucknow will be the first artificial intelligence city, and the UP government will provide almost 40 acres of land for this project. Next, name the extremist or insurgent organization of Northeast region that recently signed a memorandum of settlement, that is a peace contract, with the government of India and Assam. So which is that insurgent group? It is your United Liberation Front of Assam, right? They have recently signed a peace treaty or peace pact. It was with the government of India and Assam state, correct? Along with United Liberation Front of Assam, they signed this peace treaty with government of India and Assam state, right? Take a note of this. This is important. And here, 29 member delegation of this United Liberation Front of Assam. Among these, 16 ULFA members and 13 civil society members signed this peace treaty in the presence of Amit Shah, who is our Home Minister. If we talk about this United Liberation Front of Assam, this is the oldest insurgent group, right? It is the oldest insurgent group in the state of Assam. It was formed in April 1979 after the agitation against the undocumented immigrants from Bangladesh. Next, which country's Lamdong province along with the Leh region of Ladakh? India has recently launched a cultural exchange and tourism cooperation initiative with the theme Ladakh Unveiled. So which country's Lamdong province along with the Leh region of Ladakh in India has recently signed a cultural exchange and tourism cooperation initiative with the theme Ladakh Unveiled? It will be Vietnam. Correct. So Lamdong province, this is in Vietnam. Correct. And Leh region of India, they recently together signed a cultural exchange and tourism cooperation initiative, And the theme for this was, you have to remember this theme, Ladakh Unveiled. Right, where was this signed? Location, where was this signed? It was signed in Da Lat, that is in Vietnam. Correct? And it was mutually agreed by both the parties to promote each other's unique destinations as a premier tourist hub, and also to work towards the culture exchange, as tourists will be moving from one country to other country, that is between India and Vietnam, and also tourism cooperation initiatives, right? So tourism will also be boosted here. Next, the Ministry of Heavy Industries extended the PLI scheme for automobile and auto components by dash year with partial amendments. So Ministry of Heavy Industries, they extended the PLI scheme. PLI is your product linked incentive scheme, and under this PLI scheme, the government is giving incentives to on the production of various products, right? And here remember, these incentives will be provided to these manufacturing units only when they complete a specific, or they touch a specific quota that will be provided to them. So Ministry of Heavy Industries, they extended this PLI scheme for automobile and auto components by which year? So they have been extended by 1 year with partial amendment, right? And why amendments? This is to provide clarity and flexibility under this scheme, and the incentive disbursement will be made in the subsequent financial year of fiscal year 25. Next, DRDO celebrated their Dash Foundation Day or Raising Day on 1st of Jan 2024. So DRDO celebrated their 66th Foundation Day or Raising Day on 1st of February, right? On 1st of February. So DRDO, it was established in 1958, and this year in 2024, it was the 66th Foundation Day of DRDO, right? It was observed on 1st January, right? Take a note of this. Next, which state has recently recognized as the Petro Capital of India? So which is the Petro Capital of India? It is Gujarat. Gujarat is known as the Petro Capital of India, and RIL Jamnagar Refinery, that is Reliance Industries Limited's Jamnagar Refinery Complex, is the largest and most complex single site refinery in the world. Apart from this, remember, two semiconductor manufacturing plants will be coming up in Gujarat, and one manufacturing plant will be in Assam that will be set up with the help of Tata. Next, Department of Pension and Pensioners Welfare amended the Central Civil Service Pension Rules dash year to allow female government servant or pensioners to nominate her children for family pension in precedence to her husband. So Department of Pension and Pensioner Welfare amended the Central Civil Service Pension Rules of which year? Of 2021, to allow female government servants pensioner to nominate her child or children for family pension in precedence to her husband. Right, take a note of this. In the event of the death of the female government server or pensioner during the pendency of the above proceedings, of the family pension will be disbursed, right, to widower without the eligible children, widower with the minor children, or widower with children who have attended the majority but are eligible for family pension. Next, in Jan, Dash became the first union territory in India to implement the Pradhan Mantri Vishwakarma Yojana. So it is Jammu and Kashmir, right? Jammu Kashmir became the first union territory to implement Pradhan Mantri Vishwakarma Yojana. And the training program for the first batch is of 30 trainees that are Vishwakarmas. And remember, where this will be? It is in Jammu and Kashmir. These trainings will be offered basic training for 5 to 7 days and advanced training of 15 days. Here, the trainees will be paid a stipend. Stipend is basically a money help, right? So, for their service, for this training, that is 500 rupees per day, correct? And a toolkit worth 15,000 rupees will also be provided to them. So, toolkit for 15,000 rupees and stipend of 500 rupees per day will be provided to these Vishwakarmas. Next, EPFO, Employees Provident Fund Organization, extended the deadline to upload the wage details of higher pension options online till dash. So EPFO, they extended the deadline to upload the wage details of higher pension options online till 31st of May 2024. Earlier it was 31st of December, now it has been extended till 31st of May 2024.
Next question, which state's product Adi Kekri, that is the handmade carpet, and Vancho wooden craft have recently received GI tag from Geographical Indication Registry? So these two products, they are from which state? This is the question. Adi Kekri, that is your handmade carpet, and Vancho wooden craft. So they got the GI tag, and these products are from Arunachal Pradesh, correct? And with the addition of total of three products, right? Adi Kekri handmade carpet and Vancho wooden craft. So these are the three products, right? So they got the recently GI tag, and the total number of GI tags products in Arunachal Pradesh is now 8. Next, which state government has recently declared Poila Baisakh as the state day? So Poila Baisakh as the state day has been declared by West Bengal, correct? West Bengal. And the day will be celebrated as Bangla Divas, correct? Bangla Divas. And remember, West Bengal government declared Poila Baisakh, that is the Bengali New Year, as the state day and Nobel laureate Rabindranath Tagore's, right? That is the soil of Bengal and the water of Bengal, that is the state song. Coming back, Poila Baisakh, remember, it is celebrated on the first day of the Baisakh month, that is the first month of the Bengali calendar, which usually falls on 14th or 15th of April. Then if we talk about Rabindranath Tagore, he received Nobel Prize in Literature in 1913, and he became the first Indian and first Asian to win the Nobel Prize in Literature from India and Asia. Moving on, which state recently celebrated the 14th edition of Chandubi Festival? So 14th edition of Chandubi Festival was celebrated by Assam state, right? It was the 14th edition. It was from 1st to 5th of January we observed this Chandubi Festival, and the festival celebrates the cultural heritage of Assam's tribal communities such as Rabhas, Garos, Gorkhas, etc. that live near the Chandubi Lake. Moving on, which state's product, that is Tengel cotton sarees, Koryal sarees, and Garad silk sarees, have recently received the GI tag status from GI registry? It is West Bengal, correct? So Geographical Indication Registry under DPIIT, they recently awarded GI tags to three handloom sarees of West Bengal that were named Tengel, Koryal, and Garad, and they received the GI tag under the goods of textile, correct? So these are the three sarees that you need to remember: Garad, silk sarees. Next, which of the following products of Odisha did not receive GI tag status from Geographical Indication Registry in Jan? So among the following product that did not receive GI tag is Vancho wooden craft, right? Rest all the product recently got the GI tag, right? And the total number of GI tags from Odisha is 25. Next, in Jan, Indian Navy's Information Management and Analysis Center, that is in Gurugram, Haryana, is set to be upgraded into National Maritime Domain Awareness Center in about 3 years. Question asked here is that which company is entrusted with the responsibility of providing all the requested hardware and software necessary for NMDA? It will be your Bharat Electronics Limited, right? So Indian Navy's Information Management and Analysis Center, this is located in Gurugram, Haryana,
right? And this is said to be upgraded into NMDA in about 3 years. What is NMDA? National Maritime Domain Awareness. And this NMDA aims to address the maritime challenges in the Indian Ocean region. Next, in which state Union Minister of Health and Family Welfare Mansukh Mandaviya has recently inaugurated Prasadam, that is India's first healthy and hygienic food street. So Prasadam, that is India's first healthy and hygienic food street, it was inaugurated by Mansukh Mandaviya. Question asked is, name the state where this was inaugurated. So it was inaugurated in Madhya Pradesh. Right, who is the Chief Minister of Madhya Pradesh? Dr. Mohan Yadav. And Mohan Yadav along with other dignitaries were present during the inauguration of this Prasadam. Right, and in this Prasadam, that is India's first healthy and hygienic food street, there were a total of 17 shops that is spread across 939 square meters and that offer convenient and culturally rich dining options to various devotees of Mahakaleshwar Temple. Next, which state's transport corporation has recently launched Bayu, that is India's first 100% electric and decentralized open mobility electric bike taxi services, that is Bayu. Right, Bayu. What is Bayu? India's first 100% electric and decentralized open mobility e-bike taxi service. Which is the state that has launched this Bayu? It was launched by the state of Assam. Correct. Next, and remember Bayu, they have also launched a Bayu clean air movement. Right, and it is a sustainability mobility initiative launched by the Assam State Transport Corporation. Next, India's first 31 meter single span U grider was successfully cast for Dash City's suburban rail project. So in January, India's first 31 meter single span U grider was successfully casted for Bangalore City's suburban rail project. Right, and remember these griders will be used for the construction of elevated section of around 8 kilometers from Hebbal to Yashwantpur, that is a part of the Mileage Line or Corridor 2 of BSRP. BSRP is your Bangalore Suburban Rail Project. Next, as per the report, MSMEs Unleashing the Engines of Economic Prosperity, prepared by CBRE India Research in Jan 2024, Dash State has accounted for the highest share, that is 17% of MSMEs in India. Correct. So according to this report, Maharashtra is the state that accounts for 17% of MSMEs in India. Right, that is the highest share. This is followed by Tamil Nadu on second position, that is 10%. Followed by Uttar Pradesh on third position with 9% of MSME share. And this CBRE India Research, remember this is the knowledge partner of New India Summit 2024. And we know MSME sector, it plays a vital component in the economic progress of India that contributes to nearly 30% of India's GDP and 44% of the India's export. Next, in which city the International Kite Festival was inaugurated in Jan 2024? So in Ahmedabad, Gujarat. Right, the International Kite Festival was inaugurated in Jan 2024. The festival will be held from 7th to 14th of January 2024 in Ahmedabad city, and this festival, it marks the days in Hindu calendar when winter begins turning to summer, known as Makar Sankranti. And the festival features over 153 international kite flyers from 53 countries, 68 national flyers from 12 states, and 865 kite enthusiasts from 23 cities in the state of Gujarat. And since 1989, this festival, International Kite Festival, is celebrated in the city of Ahmedabad. Next, in Jan, the Inland Waterways Development Council committed an investment of dash amount for development of river cruise tourism in India in its first meeting. So IWDC, that is Inland Waterways Development Council, committed an investment of 45,000 crore rupees for development of river cruise tourism in India in its first meeting, right? And remember, 35,000 crore rupees of this sum has been allocated for cruise vessel, and 10,000 crore rupees is set for the development of cruise terminal infrastructure by 2047, right? And here remember, Harit, Nauka, these are the green transition guidelines, or these are the guidelines for the green transition of inland vessel that was launched, correct? Launched by whom? Launched by our union minister. Who is our union minister of Port, Shipping and Waterways? Sarbandana Sonowal ji. Next, which state government has recently launched a new social welfare scheme, that is Yogashri, for scheduled caste and scheduled tribe students? So for scheduled tribe and scheduled caste students, new social welfare scheme Yogashri was launched. Question asked is, which state government has launched this Yogashri? It was launched by the state West Bengal, and West Bengal's chief minister Mamata Banerjee has launched this Yogashri, that is a new scheme. This was launched in Kolkata, West Bengal, and under this Yogashri scheme, 50 centers will be opened across the state where scheduled caste and scheduled tribe students will be able to take training completely free of cost for competitive exams. Next, the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare notified the revised pharma manufacturing rules under the Schedule M guidelines of the Drugs and Cosmetic Rules of which year? Of 1945, in the Gazette of India. So right option is option 4. And why were these Scheduled M, revised Schedule M has been notified? Because it is to ensure good manufacturing practices, right? If we are having good manufacturing practices, our quality of product will be good, and if the quality of product is good, then it will help us to fetch good price in export in the international market, right? Next, DGCA, that is Directorate General of Civil Aviation, introduced substantial revisions to its flight duty time limitations regulations to address fatigue among pilots and crew and enhance the overall flight safety. DGCA has increased the mandatory weekly rest period for flight crew to 48 hours from the previous 36 hours. Right, I repeat, the mandatory weekly rest period for flight crew has been increased from 36 hours to 48 hours. Next, Indian Army was officially declared Indian Army has officially declared 2024 as the year of technology adoption. So right option here becomes option 2, as the 2024 as the year of technology adoption. Absorption, not adoption, absorption, right? And this symbolizes a dedicated commitment to integrate cutting-edge technologies, new age generation technologies, and fostering development and promoting innovation. Next, InGen Dash became the first international organization for standardization certified petroleum organization in India. So it is Haldia Petrochemicals Limited. It became the first international organization for standardization, ISO IEC 27001-2022-2022 certified petrochemical organization in India. And this certification was awarded by UK based certification body, that is BSI, British Standards Institution, in a ceremony that was held in Kolkata, West Bengal. Next, which tiger reserve has recently designated as the India's first dark sky park and Asia's fifth park for promoting the night sky? Which is that tiger reserve? It is Panch Tiger Reserve. This Panch Tiger Reserve is located in the state of Maharashtra, and it has been designated as India's first dark sky park and Asia's fifth park for protecting the night sky and preventing the light pollution. This dark sky place certification focuses on lightning policy, dark sky friendly, and also providing education and monitoring the night sky. So it is your Panch Tiger Reserve of Maharashtra that has been designated as India's first dark sky park and Asia's fifth park for protecting the night sky. Next, which state government has recently launched Mukhyamantri Mahila Udyamita Abhiyan, that is a scheme to develop 4 million self-help group women as rural micro entrepreneurs. So which is that state? It is the state of Assam, right? Assam state government recently launched Mukhyamantri Mahila Udyamita Abhiyan, and this will help to develop 4 million, that is 40 lakh self-help groups, women as rural micro entrepreneurs. And the outlay for the scheme is 4,000 crore rupees, and it will be offered to self-help group members who are committed to personal business plans along with their group activity. Correct? And the aim here is to make these self-help group women a Lakhpati, right? That means elder sisters, Lakhpati didis are basically to help them earn 1 lakh rupees per annum or yearly income. Next, the Ministry of New and Renewable Energy launched the new solar power scheme with an outlay of dash for electrification in habitations and villages of particularly vulnerable tribal groups. So in Jan, Ministry of New and Renewable Energy, they launched the new solar power scheme with an outlay of 515 crore rupees for electrification in habitation and villages of particularly vulnerable tribal groups. The scheme was launched under Pradhan Mantri Janjati Adivasi Nyay Abhiyan program, and the scheme was launched for the tenure expanding from financial year 24 to financial year 26. Next, Union Minister of Defence Rajnath Singh has approved the proposal to launch group insurance scheme for casual paid labours engaged by Border Road Organisation General Reserve Engineer Force, and the scheme provides how much amount as an insurance to CPL's families next of kin in case of death. So this scheme provides a how much amount? 10 lakh rupees as insurance to CPLs, that is your casual paid labors, right, to their families or the next of kin in the case of death. So 10 lakh rupees will be provided under this insurance. Next, according to recent Niti Aayog's report, that is National Multidimensional Poverty, a progress review 23 released in January, dash individuals emerged from the multidimensional poverty between 2013-14 and 22-23. So according to Niti Aayog's report, National Multidimensional Poverty, a progress review, a total of 24.82 crore individuals emerged from the multidimensional poverty between fiscal year 2014 to fiscal year 23. Between this period, almost 24.82 crore people emerged out of poverty, right? And in this data, the state that has topped is Uttar Pradesh with 5.94 crore people who emerged out of poverty. This was followed by Bihar, followed by Madhya Pradesh. Next, the National Highway Authority of India launched One Vehicle, One Fastag initiative to discourage user behavior of using a single Fastag for multiple vehicles. Under the initiative, Fastags was incomplete KYC to get that deactivated and blacklisted by bank post since dash. Correct, I repeat. So NHAI, they have launched One Vehicle, One Fastag initiative to discourage the user behavior of using single Fastag for multiple vehicles. And under this initiative, Fastag with incomplete KYC will be deactivated or blacklisted by banks, say from 31st of January 2024. You won't be able to use. Even now, many of those Fastags were associated with Paytm, and now it has been shut down. And from Paytm only now you can apply for HDFC Fastag. Next, in Jan, VK Saraswat, the member of Niti Aayog inaugurated India's first National Highway steel slag rod section on National Highway 66 that will be connecting what? So this first National Highway steel slag rod section on National Highway 66 will be connecting Mumbai and Goa. It was inaugurated by V.K. Saraswat, who is a member of Niti Aayog. Right, this will be a 4-lane road stretch for about 1 kilometer. Moving on, the Indian Meteorological Department celebrated their 150th Foundation Day. IMD developed an in-house web geographic information system based integrated decision support system called Weather Analysis and Forecast Dash System. So simply WAFES, full form of this WAFES being asked, what is this? What does this stands for? Weather Analysis and Forecast Enabling System, right? So IMD developed this in-house web geographic information system that is GIS based integrated decision support system called WAFES, and WAFES stands for Weather Analysis and Forecast Enabling System, right? And this was to celebrate 150th Foundation Day of India Meteorological Department. Next, as per the third advance estimate of area and production of various horticulture crops for 2022-23 released by Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare in January, the estimation of the total horticulture production for 2022-23 is about 355.25 million tons. Correct? And as per the estimation of the total horticulture production, that is about 8.07 million tons. Increase, that is 2.32% increase than fiscal year 22. Correct. Next, in which state Ash Krishnan, the Secretary of the Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology, has recently launched India's first Graphene Center and Indian Innovation Center for Graphene and Center of Excellence in Intelligent Internet of Things Sensor. So where was this launched? It was launched in Kerala, right? It was inaugurated and launched, that is India's first graphene center, right? Where was it? It was in Kerala. First graphene center. Second, remember, the center of excellence in IoT sensors, that is intelligent internet of thing sensors. They both were inaugurated where? In the state of Kerala. Next, in Jan, Dash became the first state in India to launch a regenerative tourism model to redefine tourism. So it is Goa. They became the first state in India to launch a regenerative tourism model to redefine tourism. This model aims to promote 11 spiritual sites under Ek Dasha Tirath campaign, and the model was launched to mark 62nd anniversary of the liberation of Goa, that was on 19th of December 2020. Next, Prime Minister Narendra Modi released 6 special commemorative postage stamps that are dedicated to Sri Ram Janmabhoomi Temple that is located in Ayodhya, Uttar Pradesh. Direct question and simple question. Correct? And these 6 distinct stamps, they include the description of Ram Janmabhoomi Temple, Lord Ganesh, Lord Hanuman, Lord Jatayu, Kevatraj and Ma Shabri. So these are the 6 commemorative stamps that were launched. Next, which state has recently celebrated the 9th edition of Pakke Pagga Hornbill Festival? Which is that state? It is Arunachal Pradesh, right? It has celebrated 9th edition of the Pakke Pagga Hornbill Festival. It was celebrated from 18th to 20th of January in 2024. And it was the 9th edition, do remember this. Next, which state's Kachchi Kharek has recently got GI tag from the Geographical Indication Registry? It is the state of Gujarat. Right? Gujarat, Kachai Kharek or Kuchi dates. Correct? Kachai Kharek or Kachchi dates, right? This is the indigenous dates. Date is basically khajur, right? And it is a variety of Kutch in the state of Gujarat that recently got the GI tag, right? And this Kachai Krek, it became the second fruit for the state of Gujarat that got the GI tag after Gir, Kesar, Mango, that was in 2011. Next, which IIT, which IIM, Indian Institute of Management, recently collaborated with the Strategy, Perspective, Planning and Monitoring Committee of the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India to develop ICAI Vision 2049. So, which IIM? It is IIM Ahmedabad. Right, IIM Ahmedabad recently collaborated with the Strategy, Perspective, Planning and Monitoring Committee of ICAI for ICAI Vision 2049. Correct, and it aims to make ICAI a global recognized leader in the field of accountancy. Next, in which company Union Minister of Petroleum and Natural Gas Hardeep Singh Puri has recently inaugurated the first pilot state-of-the-art technology project to make jet fuel from alcohol. It is Praj Industries Limited. Praj Industries Limited, right? So, Praj Industries Limited here has recently inaugurated the first pilot state-of-the-art technology project to make jet fuel from alcohol. Correct? And this project will produce sustainable biological aviation fuel. Next, Department of Higher Education under the Ministry of Education released the guidelines for regulations of Coaching Center 2024 that prohibits coaching centers from enrolling students below the age of 16. I repeat, Department of Higher Education under the Ministry of Education released the guidelines for coaching centers, right? And this prohibits the coaching centers from enrolling students below the age of 16, right? And this decision was taken among because of the rising student suicides and high fees at the study centers and mental pressures that the students are facing. Next, our Union Minister of Fisheries, Animal Husbandry and Dairying, Purushottam Rupala, has recently launched the project of depositing artificial reefs in the seabed. So, it is Kerala, right? Kerala, in which state? In Kerala, Union Minister of Fisheries, Animal Husbandry and Dairying, Purushottam Rupala recently launched the project of depositing artificial reefs in the seabed, right? And the project aims to increase the income of fishermen by enhancing the fish population in the waters of Kerala. Next, the Prime Minister Narendra Modi participated in Pran Pratishtha ceremony of Sri Ram Lalla idol in newly built Sri Ram Janambhumi Mandir in Ayodhya, Uttar Pradesh. This 51-inch Ram Lalla idol placed in the sanctum of the temple was sculpted by Arun Yogi. Remember the name Arun Yogiraj. Remember this name of the sculptor. Arun Yogiraj has recently sculpted this 51-inch Ram Lalla idol that was placed in the sanctum of the Ram Mandir that was built in Ayodhya, Uttar Pradesh. Next, in January, Air India, they have launched India's first Airbus A350-900 model aircraft, that is AI-589, from Bangalore, Karnataka to Dash City. So, Air India, they have launched India's first Airbus A350-900, right? And this model aircraft AI-589 was launched from Bangalore, Karnataka to Mumbai, Maharashtra. Right, take a note of this. Next, which state government has recently launched My School, My Pride campaign under Apna Vidyalaya program? It is Himachal Pradesh. Right, Himachal Pradesh government has launched My School, My Pride campaign under Apna Vidyalaya program. Correct, that aligns with National Education Policy of 2020. The aim of this NEP 2020 is to enhance the quality of education in the government schools. Next, Which company has recently received the approval from the Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas to establish a wholly owned subsidiary company for green energy and gas business? It is ONGC, Oil and Natural Gas Corporation. They have received the approval from Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas to establish a wholly owned subsidiary company for green energy and gas business. Next, in which city the 9th edition of India International Science Festival was held in Jan? So it was held in Faridabad, Haryana, right? The 9th edition of India International Science Festival, correct? And it was held under the central theme, that is Science and Technology, Public Outreach in Amrit Kaal. Next, in Jan, Union Minister of Home Affairs Amit Shah inaugurated and addressed the 5th International and 44th All India Criminology Conference at National Forensic Science University, that is located in Gandhinagar, Gujarat. Next is, which of the following organization along with the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare have recently launched the Investment Forum for Advancing Climate Resilient Agriculture Food Systems in India? So which is that organization? It is Food and Agriculture Organization, that is an arm of UN and Niti Aayog. So right option becomes option 3. Next, in which city Union Minister of Coal, Mines and Parliamentary Affairs Prahlad Joshi recently inaugurated the second State Mining Ministers Conference? Where was this inaugurated? It was inaugurated in Bhopal, Madhya Pradesh. Right? Take a note of this also. Important. And Madhya Pradesh, it bagged the first rank and received the award from Union Minister for recognizing their efforts in mining auction for the year, fiscal year 23. Next, in which state or UT the Dagger Division of Indian Army has recently opened India Selfie Point near the line of control? So, in which state the Dagger Division of Indian Army opened this India Selfie Point? It is in Jammu and Kashmir. Right? It is located along NH44, which is the longest national highway in India that connects Srinagar in Jammu and Kashmir to Kanyakumari in Tamil Nadu. Next, Prime Minister of India Narendra Modi launched the development projects worth more than 19,100 crore rupees in which district? In Bulandshahr district of UP. So right option, option 3. Next, who has recently been appointed as the new Chief Secretary of the Union Territory of Puducherry? So who has been appointed here as the new Chief Secretary of the UT Puducherry? Right option here will be Sharad Chauhan. Sharad Chauhan has been appointed as the new Chief Secretary of Union Territory of Puducherry. He will be replacing whom? He will replace Rajiv Verma. That is a 1992 batch IAS officer. So friends, these were your important current affairs for national affairs for the January month. Now let's move to some revision part that will be very beneficial for your learning.
10%. And similarly, this year, from 3 to 10% wages will be increasing for fiscal year 25. Then the wages have seen an average increase of almost 7% from the existing average, that is 267.32 rupees per day. It was increased to 285.47 rupees per day for fiscal year 25, and this is the rate for fiscal year 24 as of now. Correct. So this is the rate of rupees per day for fiscal year 25. Then the Goa state saw the highest hike of 10.56% over the current wage, while Uttar Pradesh and Uttarakhand, they recorded the lowest wage hike, that was 3.04%, and Goa saw the highest rise and the lowest was seen by UP and Uttarakhand. Correct. Next, then if we talk about Haryana, because we know that in Haryana there is one of the largest unemployment rate, so most of the workers will be there in Manrega. So Manrega wage rate is currently how much for Haryana state? It is 374 rupees per day in Haryana, right? And in Arunachal Pradesh, we can see the lowest rate, that is 234 rupees per day. So the highest Manrega rate is in Haryana, that is 374 rupees per day, whereas in Arunachal Pradesh it is lowest to 234 rupees per day. Next, here you can see the wages have seen almost an average of 7% increase to 285.47 rupees. Goa witnessed highest hike, that is 10.5, while UP and Uttarakhand, they saw the lowest raise, 3.04% each. Goa, Karnataka 10.4, Andhra Pradesh 10.29, Telangana 10.29, right? And Kerala and Lakshadweep saw below 4%. Here you can see, and Haryana sees the highest wage rate, that is at 374 rupees per day, whereas Arunachal Pradesh has the lowest, that is 234 rupees per day. Next, which organization opens their Indian subsidiary, that is Aerospace Services India? So it is Israel Aerospace Industries. They have recently opened their Indian subsidiary, that is Aerospace Services India, in location where they have opened it, it is in New Delhi. So the location also becomes important. Question can be asked that Israel Aerospace Industries has opened their Indian subsidiary, that is Aerospace Services India, and what is the location where they have opened it? It is in New Delhi. And ASI, that is Aerospace Services India, ASI acts as the authorized OEM, original equipment manufacturer, right, for the medium range surface to air missile system that will be used by Indian Army and Indian Air Force system. I repeat, this ASI, Aerospace Services India Limited, this will be acting as the OEM. OEMs are your original equipment manufacturers, right? And they will be acting OEM for the medium range surface to air missile system that will be used by Indian Army and Indian Air Force as well as Indian Navy. Right, this system, this is an advanced array radar, correct, and it will be having mobile launchers, interceptors with advanced RF seeker also. Then this MRSAM, this has been jointly developed by DRDO and BDL, Bharat Dynamics Limited. Do note this. And who will be acting as their original equipment manufacturer? It will be Aerospace Services Limited, Aerospace Services India, that is located in New Delhi, and that is an Indian subsidiary of Israel Aerospace Industries. Next is, according to UNDP, United Nations Development Programs report, globally how much percent of the food produced was wasted in 2022? So if 100 of the total food was produced, out of this 100, a total of 19%, that is 19 food was wasted in 2022. This data was released by United Nations Development Program, right? Oh, I correct, this is not UNDP, it is UNEP, United Nations Environment Program. This data was released by UNEP, United Nations Environment Program. Headquarter of UNEP is in Nairobi, Kenya. SBI Mutual Fund acquired how much percent stake in Savita Oil Technologies? So SBI Mutual Fund, they acquired a total of 3% stake in Savita Oil Technologies Limited, and this 3% equity stake is equivalent to 20.73 lakh shares, right? And this was acquired by SBI Mutual Fund. 3% they acquired, and they acquired in Savita Oil Technologies.
That's all for the day, friends. I hope you enjoyed the session, and you can follow us on the YouTube channel, as well as apart from YouTube channel, you can go and follow us at Affairs Cloud Telegram channel. And if you have any queries related to the content or the of courses offered to you or the payment which you did on the application, you can contact us on the number provided, that is 7677333862. Apart from this, friends, you can follow us on the Facebook as well as on Instagram handle, that is affairscloud_official. In the end, friends, if you use a code, that is Vikas10, you will be getting an additional extra 10% discount by using this code Vikas10. Also, if you have any problem regarding the course purchase, any problem regarding to our application, you can contact us on the mobile number, that is 9677333862. And if you want to mail us, you can also mail us on support@affairscloud.com. And I assure you that our representative from us will be contacting you soon and resolving your issue.